So these xy equations that connect to each other, these are called relationships. It's really important to understand that relationships can be shown in lots of different ways. So we've just used the equation to generate a table of values, and we use the table of values to graph. But these things are all just interconnected. If I have table of values of a pattern, I can come up with a graph of it, and I can somehow come up with an equation. So we still need to develop some skills to do some of these things. For example, to go from the graph to the equation or the table to the equation. But this is what we're going to start working on. This is what we're going to be focusing on. And this idea of understanding that there's a relationship, and we're going to graph the relationship, and the relationship shows up as a picture, is really important. So anytime we have one of these components, for example, data table, that's just one form of describing a relationship. And there must be some graph related to it. There must be some equation related to it. Okay? So we're going to start working on getting used to dealing with relationships, understanding relationships, interpreting them, and being able to convert them from one form to the other. So that's very important that we start doing this, because this is a large part of what high school math is going to be about, looking at relationships and also graphing relationships and understanding how to go between these three forms.